What a lot of people are talking about in the NFL, and quite frankly outside the NFL, which is why he's such a polarizing and interesting figure, is what's going to happen Saturday in Atlanta when Colin Kaepernick, at this point, is still going to work out for at least seven football teams in a workout perpetuated and made possible not by any one team but by the NFL. So for more on all of this, we are delighted to be joined finally on Golic and Wingo by Domonique Foxworth from The Undefeated, played for the Broncos, Falcons, and Ravens, worked with the NFLPA, at one time was the president of the NBA Players Association, so he knows things. Domonique, thanks for being with us this morning. What do you think is actually going to happen Saturday in Atlanta?
I mean, I assume that Colin Kaepernick is going to go out there and he's going to fare well, and I honestly, the more I've been thinking about it, I think he's going to be on a team relatively soon. Because it doesn't make sense. So the only way that you can justify the NFL orchestrating this workout is if they think it's going to end in success. And as I would evaluate success is him being on the roster, because Colin Kaepernick was out of the news. No one was bashing the NFL over this. We had kind of moved on and forgotten about it. And why bring this back up unless you feel very strongly that he's going to end up on the team? Because all this does is reopen them to this criticism, and it makes them look like they're just putting up this farce. And so, I mean, I don't know, obviously, but I have a feeling that the only other way I can explain it is that the NFL is stupid, frankly. Like, why would you reintroduce this if it's not going to end in what would be, everyone, I think, would consider a success of Colin Kaepernick making his way back in the league, presuming that he's going to stand for the national anthem or at least stay in the locker room for it?
Our talk here, is for me anyway, has been the NFL is bailing out the teams that didn't have the guts to bring him in for an individual workout. They're tired of the teams calling them, so they said, here's a workout. Everybody who wants to go to it can go to it. And as far as, you know, Colin Kaepernick, he has a chance to work out for teams. I think he'll absolutely take that chance. And, oh, by the way, I think he'll look great on the field. So let's take away that part of it. He's throwing in shorts and T-shirts. So if he doesn't look good, that's on him. He says he's been working out. He's going to look just fine. Now, if you're one of those teams, Domonique, and you get him in the room then to interview him, what questions are you asking him?
Yeah, I don't think you need to ask him those questions, and I don't think you should ask him the questions about kneeling or standing or the national anthem. I think if you want him on your team, you have come to grips with the fact that what he was doing was not disrespectful to the flag or the troops. It was by going to a knee, he was doing what he thought was much more respectful than sitting down, and I think you've come to grips with that, and you are prepared for anything that comes, whether he decides to do it or not. I think it's unlikely that he'll take a knee at this point, or raise a fist or have any sort of demonstration. Of course, I can't climb into his head, but I think it's unlikely because I see him as a practical and pretty smart guy, and I think he realizes that he has already created the attention that he wanted to create, and he is already a symbol for social justice and civil rights in this country, and I think he realizes that doing anything else at this point, demonstration-wise, like, that gains you no more ground. He has the platform, he has the attention, he has the respect, he has the credibility. All that is there, and if he stands for the national anthem, I don't think anyone loses any credibility or respect for him, and he can still continue to work towards creating the future that he wants to create by standing or even staying in the locker room. I think that that's something that most people would not find offensive. And the kind of the one person, the president, who's been able to kind of marshal a lot of the anti-Kaepernick rhetoric, his most recent comments said that he thought that Kaepernick should be back in the league given that he can play. So I think that he is in a good position to get back in the league and a good position to succeed.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. And for more sports highlights and analysis, be sure to download the ESPN app. And for premium content plus live streaming, make sure to subscribe to ESPN Player.